Everyone, Aga here, the holistic health coach at Candida Cleanser. And today's video, I want to talk about the difference between Candida and SIBO, small intestinal bacterial overgrowth. So in my clients and in the community, the Facebook community that I help manage, we are beginning to see a lot of talk and hype about SIBO, but there's a lot of misunderstanding about it and also misunderstanding about Candida. The two conditions are very different, but their symptoms overlap. So we're finding that a lot of people who have Candida might also have SIBO, and they're working their ass off to get at Candida, but some of these symptoms are still persisting, but it's actually SIBO. And it's important to know the difference between the two because the treatments vary. They're very, very different. So to begin to understand the two, let's talk about the gut microbiome, your gut flora. There are hundreds, trillions of bacteria living in your digestive system, and a majority of them are actually in the colon. This is where that majority of the microbial activity happens, and you want good, healthy gut bacteria, but there's also yeast and parasites and fungus growing in there, but the key is to have a lot of healthy, good gut bacteria to keep all of that in check. But what's happened is that there is a state of gut dysbiosis. Things have happened in our life, be it food, pharmaceutical drugs, surgeries, birth control, chlorinated water. What happens is there's not enough good gut bacteria and our gut goes into dysbiosis. There's too many unhealthy gut microbes beginning to flourish. And Candida yeast is one of those. The Candida yeast grows and grows and grows and turns into a fungus, a fungal infection. It's different than the yeast. When it's a fungus, it grows an exoskeleton made of chitin, the same stuff that a lobster is covered in, ticks, cockroaches, fleas. They have that really hard, bulletproof, almost exoskeleton. Nothing in the human body can get past this. And so now we have this fungus, which is impenetrable, is beginning to grow roots like a plant through soil, through your gut lining, to penetrate it, to create something called leaky gut. Now with these roots on the inside of your body, it can spread and grow systemic. And Candida fungus growing those roots, causing leaky gut, and sending out, you know, over 70, 80 toxins a day into your body that's attacking your liver, attacking your immune system. Basically, the whole body's under attack. And so the symptoms of Candida can be digestive. It can be constipation, diarrhea, bloating, cramps, kind of like IBS symptoms, heartburn, gastritis. That the entire digestive tract is out of balance, so it's very common. And anytime you have digestive issues, it can be directly reflected in the mind, in our mental state. So first it could be brain fog, forgetfulness, but it can turn into anxiety. It can turn into depression, inability to concentrate, things like this. Very, very common to be connected with Candida, the toxins that are in our system, and leaky gut. It can also grow on our skin, so we can have rashes and hives. It can be messing with our endocrine system, so we can have fatigue, adrenal fatigue, chronic fatigue, autoimmune conditions, fibromyalgia, like the list goes on and on and on. Whereas, so that's Candida in a nutshell. Whereas SIBO, small intestinal bacterial overgrowth, it's bacteria. So remember earlier I said most of the bacteria is living in the colon? Well, with SIBO, it's actually the microbes have moved up and they live in the small intestine. And we're not supposed to have much microbial activity in the small intestine. That's where our body digests our food and pulls in nutrients. Bacteria ferment food, and that's why we want them in the lower colon for the fermentation process to happen down low. But with SIBO, with the small bacteria living in the small intestine, fermentation is happening way too early. So now we can experience bloating, but kind of like in the upper portion of the body. Also fatigue. These microbes are releasing hydrogen and methane, so we can be burping. We can have nausea, there's that bloating, but also they're creating toxins in the wrong part of the digestive system. So we can feel achy, fatigued, we can have rashes. And again, it can be mirrored in our mental health with depression, with brain fog, all these things. So two very different causes, but they manifest in the body in a very similar way, SIBO and Candida. But the two are different. One is bacteria and one is fungus. And so naturally, we want to treat them differently. And before going to treatment, I want to share two of the main reasons of causes of SIBO. So number one is not enough stomach acid. And there's a big, big misunderstanding that, you know, our stomach acid, that there's just too much stomach acid, or the obsession with the alkaline diet that we need to be alkaline, acid is bad. Acid serves a point in our body. There are parts of our digestive tract that need acidity, the stomach being the one, because it's your number one prevention system against bacteria. And if there's not enough stomach acid that basically kills the bacteria that's coming in with the food, then nothing is sterilized enough and bacteria begin to live in the small intestine. So that's number one. So opiates are a real cause of low stomach acid. If you're taking proton pump inhibitors, that's another reason. Also, having a fungal infection causes poor stomach acid secretion. So you can see now how having candida that stunts your stomach acid can then give birth to SIBO. And another cause is malfunctioning of something called your migrating motor complex. And this is a form of peristalsis, basically muscle contractions through the small intestine. And its purpose is to clear the small intestine of bacteria and leftover food. And this happens in hours of fasting, between meals, and when you're sleeping. But what happens is if that wave isn't working properly, it's not sweeping out the bacteria and the food, they end up sitting there and living in there. And we don't want that. And the cause, one of the causes of the malfunctioning of this MMC complex are opiate painkillers, are pharmaceutical drugs. If you've ever had a surgery or a car accident or an abnormal anatomy, adhesions to the small intestines can also affect this. So I see this actually in a lot of clients of mine where they had perfect health, and then they went in for a surgery like a hysterectomy or hip surgery or some sort of invasive surgery in that area. And all of a sudden their health is not the same. They have brain fog, bloating, their digestive system just not the same, their immunity. And it ends up being SIBO or candida or both, because surgeries are quite stressful for the body for many reasons. So the two factors that can give into a SIBO infection are that migrating motor complex, that house sweeping action in the system isn't happening, and low stomach acid secretion. So those are the reasons why we can get SIBO. And the testing for the SIBO and candida also differ. So with SIBO, it's a lot easier. We can do a breath test. When we have bacteria living in the small intestine, they produce hydrogen and methane. So you can blow and the device can pick up on what kind of gases you're emitting from your mouth, and it could show you if you have SIBO or not. So this is one of the standard procedures that takes about 3 hours to do. Whereas checking for candida, it's a little more trickier than that. You know, stool samples often come back with false negatives, so they're not 100%. One of the more standard ones that can give you a good positive is an IgG, a blood test for testing for the antibodies for candida. But again, time and time again, we working with clients for 6+ years now, we often see that there's false negatives all the time. And if you have symptoms, these symptoms that I'm speaking of, it can be a candida infection. If it's systemic, if it's migrated out of the gut, it's not even living in the gut, so you won't be able to poop it out, right? It can be living somewhere else. So these pathogens can hide. They do a really good job at hiding and masquerading themselves as other conditions in the body. So if any of this is ringing some bells and you're like, okay, this is beginning to make sense, right? Luckily, there are two really incredible treatments that we work with. So the first one for treating candida is the CCWS, the chitin enzyme inhibitor. So basically, remember that exoskeleton I talked about with candida? It has, it grows the same stuff that the exoskeleton of ticks and lobsters and cockroaches are made out of. Well, nothing in the human body can get past it. A lot of antifungals don't do the trick, herbs also. So if you've been going at candida, you've tried difluctan and niastatin and, you know, nothing's working, the infection is still coming on, because those really don't do the trick. They can't pass that exoskeleton. The CCWS is a chitin enzyme inhibitor. It goes in there, candida all of a sudden can't make its exoskeleton, it crumbles, and your immune system can finally go in there and get at it. So that is the most effective treatment, partnered with, of course, a healthy diet that helps to heal leaky gut, boost the immune system, clear the detox pathways. So that's the treatment for candida. Pretty simple. If you need guidance through that, I work with clients. I coach people through this all the time, so feel free to reach out to me. We can work on that. SIBO is also in the mainstream medicine. If you're going to go to your doctor, they would often give you an antibiotic. And there's one called, rifaximin. It's one that is often used to treat SIBO. But what they find is that the infections come back. It can be resistant. And luckily, there are herbs. There are a combination of three, neem, burbane, and allicin. When combined together, studies have shown they are more effective than antibiotics. More effective than three rounds of antibiotics. So if you find that you are resistant to the treatment with pharmaceuticals for SIBO, this herbal treatment is the way to go. It's more effective. It's more safe on the body. Plus these herbs, they're not just isolating small intestinal bacterial overgrowth. Any kind of pathogenic bacteria that's living within the digestive system, it can get at as well. It's incredibly powerful. So I highly recommend that you check them out. I've linked below more information about SIBO so you can read up about it, links to the herbal cleanse if that's a route you want to go, and also information about candida, because the two are very different. And if you don't know, if you can't spot the difference and you're using a treatment for one that's actually meant for the other, you're not going to get the results that you want. So SIBO, one thing I forgot to mention is some of the symptoms are malnutrition. So if you are experiencing like your body's not actually pulling in nutrients that it needs, and you're losing a lot of weight, but you're still eating a lot of food and you're getting smaller and smaller and smaller, I have seen this time and time again connected with SIBO. Candida, but more so SIBO now. So again, these things can be overlapping, so you may need both treatments. So where to start, that's up to you. I often recommend to start with candida cleanser because it's easier to get at, in my opinion. And then SIBO is more isolated to the small intestine, and it can be kind of like the cherry on the top that you do in the end. But candida is systemic and causing a lot of inflammation and attacking the entire body. So it's really important that you get at that fungal infection as quick as possible, and then SIBO can be treated after. So I hope you found this video informative, educational, inspiring. It's given you a roadmap of how to move forward. And if you do need any help, any guidance, feel free to join our Facebook support group below. I believe I did link it in the comments. And if you want to work with me, I do an 8-week coaching program that's a gut healing intensive, where I guide you through the entire candida cleanser journey, supporting you through the die-off, because die-off is a doozy. It can get pretty scary when you don't know what's going on. It's normal anytime you're cleansing a pathogen to feel worse before you feel better. So if you feel like you want someone who's done this before, because I've done this before, I've done all these cleanses, I had really bad candida for over a decade, and I use this protocol to heal myself and to be here where I am today. So if you want that guide who's done it, who can understand, who has a map and is going to put you in the driver's seat, but I'll be in the passenger seat helping you the entire way, give me a shout. I also believe I did post my schedule down below. So I hope to hear from you. Have an incredible day and happy healing. Thanks for tuning in. Ciao.